us now in today's Austin Faith Dialogue.
In Spanish, it's called Manos de Cristo. In English, that's translated the Hands of Christ. It's a service of the Church of East.
Welcome to a glimpse of Saturday's cable TV lineup. This is Preview Tonight.
Today we have the opportunity to view one part of our city where human need is very near the surface. We'll also speak to those who are part of a new effort to reach into this Spanish-speaking part of our town in a way which involves board of directors, Alma Lira, a mother whose children have benefited from the El Buen Pastor Daycare Center, the services of which are related to this East Austin outreach, and to Martha Meister of Covenant Presbyterian Church, one of the congregations from the greater Austin area which has cooperated in this ministry. We welcome you all. And before we have a chance to hear from each of you, I think it would be helpful for us to have an initial look at a film that was made of the work that had started in East Austin called Manos de Cristo, with an on-site video.
Austin, the capital of Texas, the birthplace of a new creative ministry, Manos de Cristo, the Hands of Christ. East Austin is an unique community within a larger community. Although its streets are lined with large shade trees and dotted with small family-owned businesses, there's evidence of struggle here, hunger, mental and physical illness, illegal drug use, young gang activity, illiteracy, inadequate housing, discrimination, and extremely low incomes that cannot meet daily needs. Okay. Of significance also is the fact that the area has quickly become a crossroads for people migrating from Mexico, Central and Latin America, and the homeless, as Austin's mild climate provides a haven to those lacking shelter. Buenos dias. My name is Frank Diaz. I am the pastor of El Buen Pastor Presbyterian Church. We're located a few blocks from downtown Austin. We're in an area called East Austin. This is a small congregation of about 135 members. We're in a community of people of many colors. We have Hispanics, we have Anglos, we have Blacks, we have Asians. It is also a community where people immigrating from the border of Mexico and Central and South America come to live. It is a community that has many social and spiritual needs to be met. In 1988, the session of El Buen Pastor took action to develop what today is known as Manos de Cristo, or the Hands of Christ. It is a Servi Iglesia ministry with the foundation based upon the teachings of our Lord Jesus Christ when he said, when you do it to the least of these, you do it to me. Manos de Cristo attempts to be faithful to that challenge, to feed the hungry, to clothe the naked, to help the stranger in our midst, to work for social justice. Early on, we knew that we did not have the sufficient resources to do this ministry. So we extended an invitation to our fellow Presbyterians in the Austin area. And thanks be to God, they responded in a positive way by providing not only financial resources, but people coming to help us in this ministry. We're reminded of our Lord's teaching when he said, when he was asked, which is the greatest commandment? And he said, the greatest commandment is to love your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. But he said, there's another one like unto it. Love your neighbor as yourself. That is what we are attempting to do here with Manos de Cristo. Because of the needs in the East Austin community, the congregation of El Buen Pastor felt compelled to serve this disadvantaged community by challenging the Anglo-Austin area churches to join in developing a new service ministry. Participating churches appointed representatives to form a board of trustees to guide the organization in its work. One of the first duties of the board was defining the goals of Manos de Cristo. Board Chairman, Mr. Roland Castañeda, describes those goals.
Our organization has three primary goals that it would like to accomplish. First of all, we would like to transform our church, El Buen Pastor, and the others, their respective churches, into the Servi Iglesia. The Servi Iglesia is the church that is active in the community, making Christ a living reality to the people that are receiving these social services. Secondly, we would like to forge a strong and lasting permanent partnership between the Hispanic and Anglo parishioners in this community. Thirdly, our goal is to provide a holistic blending of social services that really are a bundle of basic services that are needed by these desperately indigent people, and in a manner that is not duplicative of existing social services.
Created in response to the increasing demands of both permanent and transient disadvantaged residents, as well as an overburdened and complex community resource system, Manos de Cristo combines evangelism, service, and self-help programs within its framework. Manos de Cristo initially plans to generate activity at one central location. The Manos de Cristo umbrella encompasses many components, including education, health, hunger, and clothing. Did you know that Hispanics have the highest dropout rate from school? Manos de Cristo wants to help at least a few of these children through activities that will supplement and enrich their educational experience. An after-school tutoring program is being developed to work with at-risk school-age children. Individualized tutoring in English and Spanish, homework assistance, art, outdoor games, science, and special community programs and field trips will be offered each week. In addition, we are incorporating elements in our overall educational program to address the special needs of low-income children and their parents. To meet the educational needs of young children, joint projects are being undertaken between Manos de Cristo and El Buen Pastor Early Childhood Development Center. The center provides child care to children between the ages of 2 through 5 and after school care to elementary students.
I'm looking forward to Manos de Cristo here because in turn, if I need their clothing closet, I can go over and obtain clothing for the children. If I need dental help, I can walk over and obtain dental help for the babies. To me, this is something that we are really looking forward to. It's just adding on more benefits for our children.
Special attention is given to nurturing the individual child as well as providing choices of stimulating group activities, sensitive to the community and its needs. A certain number of scholarships are offered to families experiencing financial crisis.
Okay. Thank you for that chance to take a look at what was produced there, Roland. I understand as president of the board that you were instrumental in helping develop that film, and are you pleased with it?
Well, we're very pleased with the tape as it finally resulted. I think it conveys well the message of what we're trying to do, the conditions that we are trying to grapple with, both from a social service point of view and also from the point of view of spreading the good news and sharing the good news of Christ in a community like that, and allowing parishioners both from El Buen Pastor and other churches to give life and breath to their Christian ministry. Mm-hmm. So we think the tape shows that well.
It brings out the fact that this is not simply the kind of social services that would be administered through a secular organization, that it has a spiritual dimension to it.
The Servi Iglesia concept goes a few steps further than just simply the secular approach to providing or social services to meet a human need. Mm-hmm. The persons that step forward and unite and become members of this effort look forward to opportunities to give witness to their Christian beliefs. They are quick to look for opportunities to not only give a helping hand, but also a loving word, that it would be a wonderful opportunity to kneel and pray with a family that was in need of help and spiritual support. Mm-hmm. The persons that are there to provide the clothes or in the future to provide the medical services will be not only listening to see what the material needs of that family or that person might be, but also to see if there's a need, an expressed need, or an unstated need for spiritual help.
So it's something which is on the part of those who are sharing their services and their help and their time with their volunteers from other churches and so on. It's the motivation for that comes out of their relationship to Christ.
Very much so. They want to make Christ a living reality for the persons that they are trying to serve.
All right. Well, now, Alma, I understand that you have been the recipient of services and support from the daycare program for how long?
Well, we started in 79 with my two oldest children, and it has helped them in school, and I enjoyed it because it had a spiritual atmosphere, and the teachers had a positive attitude in bringing that out on my children.
Mm-hmm. It's not the same as necessarily having taken them to a commercial daycare program.
That's right. They pray before their meals, mm-hmm. and they go to church probably once or twice during the week. The pastor comes and tells stories, or they go to the church, and I'm sure that right there they know that that's where Christ lives. Mm-hmm. That is his church.
And what's happened to those children of yours since you first took them there?
Okay, my oldest is in the Honor Society and the other one is in all honors courses. And they have grown very well.
Where are they in school now?
Fillmore, junior high.
Uh-huh. So they're...
Eighth and seventh graders.
So they've grown up a bit.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And I have my two other children in there now.
In the daycare
program?
In
the daycare also.
I see. Mm-hmm. And Martha, you're a member of Covenant Presbyterian Church,
yes.
Which is not in that particular neighborhood.
Right.
And what brought you into contact with the work there?
Well, the message at Covenant that help was needed in that area, but also I have been a school nurse in that area for 12 years, and so I know that there are needs there that are not being met, and see those expressed needs every day at work.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was very interested in helping with this project.
Well, what are some of those express needs?
Well, one of the things that we'll be meeting first is in the dental clinic. There just are not enough dental services to meet the needs that are out there.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be one of our first things that we'll be meeting as a health task force in Manos de Cristo.
And that's in addition to the services that we have first seen portrayed here?
Yes. Yes, it definitely is.
And are you lending your efforts there now in terms of your nursing skills?
No, we have not started the clinics yet. We will be starting a health clinic probably in August, July or August. It sounds realistic to us. We are in the process of leasing a building, and we'll be doing some remodeling of that building and then mm-hmm. moving in equipment.
And then you'll come into play with your,
yes.
with your nursing background?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'd like to come back to the role that the supporting churches in the city are working in relation to El Buen Pastor, but I think that before we see the second film clip, just very quickly, Roland, you're not in human services. What is your background?
Well, I'm a business law attorney, and that is generally how I make a living.
All right, and how did you happen to get involved with this program?
Well, my wife and I were involved in a similar program along the U.S.-Mexico border, Puente de Cristo, and we would travel some distance to do what needs to be done down there. Of course, poverty conditions down there are magnified 100-fold,
yes.
But we do have very severe problems here, and it I think the realization I think came on is that Austin did have glaring problems, and that I've also nurtured for many, many years, since my father was a Presbyterian minister. Mm-hmm. As a Hispanic Presbyterian child, I've always sensed that there had to be a bridge created not only between countries, but between the Hispanics and the Anglo parishioners in any given community. And I think that there's as much of that involved in this project as there is helping the needy.
Bridge building going on here in Austin.
Between churches, yes, sir.
Well, I think we'll have opportunity to see more of that as we turn now to the second of these film clips that will highlight the work of Manos de Cristo.
Many of us take communication, both the written form and conversation, for granted. But for thousands of adults, the inability to communicate hampers their daily lives. In January 1989, Manos de Cristo started an English as a second language program for Hispanic amnesty applicants seeking permanent residence status. The curriculum covers daily living situations such as how to request and give directions, how to fill out forms, and how to handle other practical routines. The students are extremely dedicated to learning. For this segment of the population, we have been living in the shadows of a foreign world. It means bringing them out into the sunlight of our community. In 1988, approximately 18,000 people were assisted with emergency food through the existing food pantry, housed at El Buen Pastor, and administered by Faith Presbyterian Church. The food pantry allows Manos de Cristo to meet the hunger needs of its clientele. To give further support to the existing on-site food pantry system, we are developing a soup kitchen to be operated on Sunday afternoons to address the needs of the homeless in the area. In October 1988, we opened the Closed Corner, which provides clothing and other basic items. Local Presbyterian Church congregations and area residents have donated all items in the Closed Corner. Volunteers man the site, as well as collect and sort donations as they come in. Clothing is free of charge, and people are encouraged to shop at a leisurely pace as they would in any retail establishment. Currently, we serve 90 to 100 people monthly. The Austin area has long needed additional dental and medical care for the indigent, especially immigrants and the homeless. Existing area services call for complicated eligibility procedures and appointment waiting periods of 8 to 10 weeks. With these in mind, Manos de Cristo, in cooperation with area dental and medical professionals, is developing a health facility that will provide basic dental and medical services to low-income families and individuals. Emphasis will also be placed on health prevention, with information materials and instruction provided on topics such as diet, hypertension, and proper oral hygiene.
For many years, the dentists and physicians of Central Texas have dreamed of having a facility where we could treat the homeless, the immigrants, the refugees, the unfortunate folks who have found themselves to be slipping between the cracks of a bureaucracy that tries to care for them. The services that will be offered will be basic. There will be basic dental surgery, lots of extraction type of care of taking out diseased teeth and getting rid of infection. There will be basic medical care, medical diagnostic care, and referring patients on out to a proper office for more sophisticated treatment. Well, we are hoping that by the end of summer 1989 that we're up and going and operational. As you can see in this, we stand here today in this empty shell of a building that we hope in a few more months has is full of equipment and is fully operational clinic. And we expect to have dentists and physicians donate a day or two a year of their time to the clinic operation and to come down here and work, probably bringing their staffs with them. It's been done very successfully in other cities, and we expect to do something of that nature. We want to provide a dignified facility, a very nice office, a first-class setup that will provide an atmosphere that we can accomplish our Christian missionary goals as well as accomplish the health care efforts also.
very simply, Manos de Cristo, the hands of Christ, is helping hands, hands reaching out to the needy, hands reaching out to the community, and hands of the people of Austin who support this ministry. How often the hands of Christ stretched out to comfort and lift people from despair. As his hands touched the needy in body and spirit, so might our helping hands bring healing and joy through caring service.
Well, this last opportunity to see the work of Manos, I think, broadens it for us, because we have had represented here the work of the dental clinic that's soon to be set up. We've had the amnesty program for those who are studying for citizenship, and the food pantry, the clothing closet, and so on, the multitude of services. I want to come back briefly, though, Martha, to what we were talking about before in regard to this dental service.
Mm-hmm.
And just how much dental service is there available to those who can't afford it in Austin today?
All right. There is a limited amount of dental service available. Austin Travis County does provide a dental clinic, but it is very hard to get appointments there. It takes a long time to get appointments, and you have to have a clinic card to qualify, be eligible to go to the dental clinic.
All right, and that means that there are relatively few that can be served in that way?
Yes, there are many more that need the service than can be served. Also, it is one of the proposed cuts in the Austin budget for the dental clinic to go. So mm-hmm. It will be even a greater need in the future, possibly.
The little there is may not be there after
right.
a certain period of time.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that one other thing that I have become aware of is that I was not calling the work that's being done in regard to the children by its proper name. What is it?
It is called Buen Pastor Early Child Development Center.
All right.
And also early, I would believe, because at the age of two, they do instill educational learning and also spiritual growth.
So the fact that it's not just daycare in the sense of taking care of youngsters while parents are working, but that there's a positive development
yes.
going on with them.
Yes.
And for instance, what in regard to issues like self-esteem, do you see the difference that makes?
Well, they ask questions, my children would ask questions in school as to why this and why that,
mm-hmm.
and the teachers go ahead and answer them, like, because is not an answer, and flowers are here for bees,
mm-hmm.
and the Lord put them here so that it can make the world look better.
But it makes them more inquiring, more inquisitive,
yes. uh-huh.
more confidence to ask questions,
yes.
whereas if they didn't have that kind of support, they might not have otherwise.
That is true.
And Roland, I think that it would probably be helpful to note the relationship that Manos has with several agencies that were mentioned here. Could you explain that?
Well, for example, the relationship between Manos and the Faith Food Pantry and also the Buen Pastor Early Childhood Development Center is a cooperative one.
Mm-hmm.
They're not legalistically speaking within our organization, but they are, and they have their own distinct existence, but we have a cooperative relationship with them, and as we go about bringing volunteers. We'll be hoping to have our volunteers assist them as we raise funds, when we will be sharing those funds in very specific ways with these other organizations. So we want to help them, and we want to help support them, because they help in turn support us in our overall
efforts. So it's a mutual relationship,
mutual cooperative
benefit.
Relationship. Yes, sir.
And you can help them with the fundraising. They can provide services that wouldn't be available otherwise.
That's correct.
Okay, I think it's that mutuality that also carries over into the larger connections in town with Covenant Church, and
yes.
I believe there are at least half dozen other churches that are related in that way.
Yes, it's a wonderful opportunity for people from other areas of Austin to come and help in an area that has the need.
And you have met our need, by the way, by being here today, all of you. I need to thank you now for your presence and your remarks, and for having had this view of church-related service rendered in East Austin. We would like to thank these participants and hope that this information and insight will be of benefit to all of you who are watching. On behalf of the Austin Metropolitan Ministries, I'm Richard Thompson, thanking you for joining us and inviting you to be with us next week. Good day.